Good morning, everyone. Let's start with our market commentary. Now, what we see in front of us is a Nifty daily chart. So as we were saying before as well, the two important milestones on the up as well as on the downside, base of Nifty is forming out to be 10,300. And if you go at the top, it is 10,600 and 650, where the upper resistance will come into play. Now, something which is important to understand from last 2 days, what has happened. After undergoing a fall, trying to retest, kind of forming a double bottom twice to 10,300 mark, it almost went sideways with small candles and then opened a little gap up on Friday itself. So after expiry, opening gap up, and there was a good pullback that basically shows some momentum coming back in the system. More than that, what I see today, which is something very good and positive, it is again opening gap up and it is now trying to reach to a higher resistance level of 10,600. So one thing is clear, there is some kind of bullishness, especially in Nifty, as far as this trend goes. And on the higher side, we are pretty much clear Nifty will find good amount of resistance in this 10,600 to 10,700 zone. Okay, so when we come back, maybe about a week or so, there might be some resistance on the upper side. Now let's see from a smaller time frame. So 15 minutes time frame basically shows the market just opened gap up. And then it did come back and test the same gap, and now it is trying to inch higher. So that basically shows a good bullishness in the system right in the morning. But the gap which is created today can be tested going further. So not today, maybe afterwards when 10,600 is done, right, and the upper resistance comes into play, it can come back and it can test this particular gap. Okay, and so the second gap is basically the Friday gap, which is 10,400. So these are the two levels of gap which have been formed in the rally of upwardness. And obviously these can come back and test both the gaps, 10,500 gap and 10,400 gap. So opening with gap up and running up basically gives us a good indication that market is trying to now get into a zone of upwardness. But you need to understand when it keeps rising fast, it can come back and again test the gaps. Second thing, if we go out and see on the hourly chart, small nitty-gritties will be very clear now. So what I see on the hourly chart, the strength of buying is basically very fast. So every hour candle that I'm seeing is basically a green candle and it is trying to inch higher. Okay. So one good point of today's opening is why is more important, because if you go out and see, there was an upper level of resistance of Moribazu at 10,485. So yesterday's market basically had spent 3 hours trying to breach this level, could not. And today it opened straight away gap up. So that basically shows inherent bullishness. And that is why I'm saying it will keep continuing to reach to 10,600 mark. Right. So it takes this particular resistance out and it has spent 3 hours over here. And then it basically tries to inch higher. Now, whenever it comes back down to this level, it will always be protected and it becomes a very good support level for Nifty. Okay, but yes, if you go out and see on the upper scale of resistance, as we were trying to say, continuous candles have basically gone on these levels of 10,600 and has undergone a fall or some kind of resistance. So I am very much clear that yes, it can come to 10,600, but taking out 10,600 will not be a cakewalk for Nifty. So 10,600 and to the level where the gap had taken place around these levels, 10,690 or 10,700. These are the two levels of bigger resistance even on the weekly front, right? So that is more important to understand. Let's go back to the daily chart. And let's put an indicator called as pivot. Just trying to understand where are the resistance and support on the higher side. So on the daily chart, I'm just trying to find some level of resistance on the higher side and support on the lower side. So for this If you see, the central pivot is somewhere around 10,800 straight away, and the support range is around 10,560, where the market is trading right now. So as I see over here, there is no big resistance zone coming into play. So which clearly means once this support is being crossed, it basically has a good upside to these resistance level, and there is no bigger resistance coming into play. Right, so that is more important to understand. Specifically, if you see the pivot now, this pivot doesn't give you a very clear indication. But for our support analysis, if you see, the basic levels of 10,600 to 700, where we were trying to see this gap, basically comes into a good forming state. So if you see, it is a kind of a U formation which is taking place by Nifty. And normally, if it takes a U formation, it does not just go up and reach 11,000 all the way. Obviously, it will get stuck somewhere over here, 600 to 700, might come back to 400, and then you might see going up towards these levels. So it has to spend some time over here. And we need to also understand if S&P is on the bullish zone or not, right? So that we will try to see. So at least on Nifty front, right now it is bullish, which is very much clear from the chart. But the upper level of 10,600 needs to be watched. When we see Bank Nifty now, same thing arises for Bank Nifty as well. So when we saw a good downturn in Bank Nifty, so if I basically take a small trend line, so every day Bank Nifty was trying to inch down, okay, and it also went below 25,000 for a day or so, but the recovery was strong and straight away gap up about 25,000 level, clearly showing a sign of reversal. And more than that, the trend line got broken and it is now trying to inch on the higher side. Now we need to understand, even the same way we did for Nifty, where it will find higher resistances. So one point is pretty much clear, 25,600 and 25,800. These are like the crucial level of resistances for Bank Nifty. Let us go inside and see intermittence level, or is there any other resistance level for Bank Nifty, or it will just keep going up. So higher resistance zone for Bank Nifty is also at 25,800 and 26,000. So till there, there can be a good upside rally for Bank Nifty. Let's understand from hourly time frame. Now, as I said, from hourly point of view also, if you see Bank Nifty, every hour the candle is bright, right? So the candle has gone green all the way after the expiry on every hourly basis. So that basically shows a very good strength coming in after a huge slump or downside. Most important, the same way as we were talking about Nifty, if you see, it went and it basically closed exactly at the point where there was a good sell-off taking place once upon a time, right? Where gap up took place and selling had happened on Bank Nifty. And this was the point 25,300. And even if you see on the upside scale, also running so fast every hour, it had to stop the day over there. So that basically showed good resistance. But now what happened in the morning, it straight away opened above that particular resistance, showing that there is a strong bullish sentiment in Bank Nifty as well. Now what you need to understand on the higher side, where is the resistance? So when I go inside and see on the hourly chart, because when we go on the intraday basis, the hourly chart is like a day chart, correct? You only have 6 bars in a day and it becomes your daily chart, like a daily chart. So hourly chart gives you a lot of importance on it for intraday basis. So when I see over here, there has been multiple times the resistance have basically been around this 25,600 odd levels. So for intraday basis, I find Bank Nifty finding good amount of resistance around the level of 25,600. So I see 100 points on Bank Nifty more, and if 100 points Bank Nifty goes up, 30-40 points, you will find Nifty inching higher. And if you see, if Nifty goes up 30-40 points, it will reach 10,600 and Bank Nifty will reach 25,600. So more or less both will enter into the resistance zone, right? So this is the two points that we know on Bank Nifty and Nifty where the resistance zone gets applied. And on the higher time frame, we are very much clear the big resistance that we see for Nifty and Bank Nifty are around the zone for Bank Nifty 25,800 to 26,000, where there is a good set of resistance which is there. Now, since the fall was steep and fast in Bank Nifty, that is why we are seeing a good surge in Bank Nifty compared to Nifty. Second thing, let's see now today's gainers and losers. So when I go out and see who are the top gainers over here, we are basically seeing Tata Motors, Maruti, Bajaj Auto. So morning it was all commodities that was in play, but now commodities are going down. Still Vedanta is also one of the gainers. But more than that, someone who is today, I would say, there in this particular pack is Auto. Right. So Auto has been going down a lot, specifically Tata Motor and Bajaj Auto. They were not showing any sign of strength. And now we find all of a sudden all the auto coming back into play because we have the numbers coming up, monthly numbers. So keep an eye on that. One thing is that, and commodities are already playing its play. More than that, gap up bullish. Now today, if you see, there are a lot of stocks which are under gap up bullish framework, right? So there is like UPL, Maruti, Bajaj Auto. So all these guys, Maruti and Bajaj Auto, have been in gap up, Tata Motor, gap up and bullish. It opened up and it is streaming up. Right, so that is one of the good upside that we have seen. What I see on the loser side, so extended list, if you see the same thing. On the downside, we also have Hindalco, Vedanta, all these guys are also there. If I see on the losing side, so losing side, it is again the pharma where it is continuously on loss. So Dr. Reddy's Sun Pharma not giving any support. But after that, if I see someone called STCS, Infosys, Wipro, Tech Mahindra, so the entire IT pack, which was streamingly high or which was screaming high from last 3 days or so, suddenly you find a good selling coming into these IT pack, right? So if today we are not seeing strength coming in from IT, but yes, we are seeing strength coming from auto also. So let's go out and see some of the auto stocks and see if in banking, is there anyone who's providing good support or not. So auto, let's first take Maruti. So Maruti, if we see over here, has basically given a good upside today. One thing which is important on Maruti, it opened gap up. And the gap up point is also very important because it was above all the prior resistances, right? Almost about the resistances. And then it is trying to inch on the higher side. So if I go out and see, let's say, even on the hourly chart. So clearly, Maruti is the winner. But if you see yesterday, day where selling had taken place and a quick reversal had happened yesterday itself, that showed when it opened gap up on Friday and trying to sustain that upper level, had a clear indication that Maruti was in the uprun. And what we saw today in the morning itself, straight away gap up and trying to take away the small resistance which was there at 8795. So this clearly showed a good positive strength for Maruti. So this is how we should understand on intraday basis whether there is some strength or not. So two times gap up. Yesterday also there was gap up. It went sideways, did not give the gains. Today again gap up and it went above the resistance zone, 8,800 mark. Right. So if it is out, now let us see how far we can see the stretch of Maruti, at least for a day or two. So I do not, I can basically anticipate a good move on the upside to 8,900 and straight away towards 9,000 or so. So you're looking at least 200 points on the upside for Maruti, which is clearly visible on the hourly chart in the first hour of the trade. If I go inside, let's say for 15 minutes or so, it might come back down. We need to basically see whether it can find some support around these levels or no. And if it finds, then there's a clear indication of 200 points upside for Maruti. So that is one of the good signals from Maruti, at least from the auto pack. Let's see now from Tata Motors. Now when I look at Tata Motors, I knew that first thing back of my mind, it is in the falling strike. Now what I saw yesterday or like last week or so towards the expiry, it had a great slump and yet it was going down. So Tata Motor is something having a very rough ride, but what I see from today's uptick, it has opened same way, as I said, little gap up, and after gap up, it is now trying to push itself higher. Okay, so there is a same case applying for Tata Motor as well, the way we did for Maruti. But what we see on Tata Motor, it is now in the resistance zone, right? So 373 becomes a very good resistance zone, but after that, straight away 381 is there on the cards. But more than that, on Tata Motor, there is a good upside rally which can be in Maruti compared to Tata Motor. But what we see over here, if it comes back down, it can find support at 363. Now let us go inside and see on the hourly chart, does these level, upper level of resistance. So if you see over here, right in the morning, it opened up and it zoomed, right? So pretty much all the gains are already done for Tata Motor for the day. It becomes difficult for Tata Motor now to inch higher, because now there is a resistance at 373 also, and there is a resistance at the current level 371 also. So these are the levels where Tata Motor might take some time to shoot up. But what I see over here, it can come back down and then it can retrace this to inch towards 380 or so. So that's clearly possible, but you need to keep an eye on. But more, the Maruti seems to be more structurally sound compared to Tata Motors. Last, let us take Bajaj Auto. So Bajaj Auto, we were bullish because of the good upside which we saw on Friday itself, reversal kind of formation. But what I see today, which is more important in Bajaj Auto, first, it has opened gap ups. As I said, all the auto companies that we are looking are in gap up mode. But when you go inside this, so there has been a good downside which has taken place. Now let's go inside on the hourly basis. The things become very, very clear what is actually happening in this particular stock. So when I go inside on the hourly basis, as I said, from Friday itself, we were bullish because it went down. It basically formed a good bottom formation over here, and then it rally took place, and then it basically came back. And today what we saw at the end closing, there was small rally, but today it basically opens and it is trying to inch on the higher side. So straight opening and trying to go up basically shows a good upside. But important for the entire thing of the upside is this level of 3080 or so, which can easily be achieved. Now, because there is a good runway on the upside, since the fall was fast, the rise can be faster. I would suggest, I can say basically the fall was basically from this end. If you see a continuous fall took place, now it is trying to reverse on the upside. So this level can easily be achieved itself, right? So on intraday basis, it looks fantastic. Set up Maruti as well as Bajaj Auto. We can basically, if you see now, it is trying to retrace a bit on 15-minute chart. And that is where it will give you a buying opportunity also. But the agenda is pretty much clear. After morning shoot up, might come back or down because Nifty might also lose the gain, but it will find some reversal for the higher side to come into play, right? So Maruti and Bajaj Auto seems to be structurally very good trades or good setups, even on the intraday basis and for next couple of days or so. So that's your auto pack. Now let's take banking. Now in the banking side, we were discussing about two banks where we were strong. One is the Kotak Bank and IndusInd Bank. Now when I see Kotak Bank, from last 3 days, even after the before the expiry also, it was showing strength, and it is now showing follow-up strength as well. So it was entering in the resistance level and it basically stopped at this gap. And what I see today morning, it basically zoomed that level as well. So that basically shows a good upside in Kotak Bank. And understand from the basic flow, the correction came in. Okay, it went almost sideways, not flat, but structurally on the vertical side. Okay, on the upside, I can say. And now it is inching higher, which basically shows a good strength in the bank called Kotak Bank. Right, buying is coming in Kotak, but the point is, we can, should we enter over here? Not at all. Let him correct, and sometimes when Nifty corrects, this guy will also correct, or Bank Nifty corrects, and then you can look for these kind of good banks to bank on. IndusInd Bank had undergone a good correction. So if we see over here, from the point where the correction took place and even at the expiry, it just went down. So the correction was very fast for IndusInd Bank, something which was very important on IndusInd Bank. If you see, it was the important level 1580 or 1600. and the reversal took place, and then it basically two important things which happened on IndusInd Bank. It basically breached the prior resistance, and now it basically opened today. It opens gap up and goes above this straight away, keeping its runway open for 1,700 or so. Right. So IndusInd Bank still has some steam to go. 10,1700 is straight away on the cards. So these kind of falls in good structural stocks should be considered, because once the fall happens, the reversal takes place very, very fast. And the point from where the fall has happened, it will come back to the same point. Right. So that is where we are trying to see. And if you see, there is no resistance now for IndusInd Bank. Straight away towards 1700 is on the cards. So these are like two solid banks, I would say, which is providing support to Bank Nifty. If you see Bank, Yes Bank was also showing support from the bottom. But if I see today, after a quick reversal, it is now today giving away the gains. So yes, but one thing is clear, even on Yes Bank, the fall has happened, trying to reverse. And on the lower end, if 316 is not breached, you can find good support coming in on Yes Bank as well. ICICI, Axis Bank, they were a tad bit low. So these are not performing on the Bank Nifty side. Agreed that after the fall, it is trying to inch high. So same as Yes Bank, Axis Bank also is not gaining strength, or ICICI is also not gaining strength. But these can be gaining strength if Bank Nifty tries to go further high. So if Bank Nifty goes high for 100, 200 points, you can see good upside coming in. Now what we see on the Axis Bank, it is trying to go up. Important point for us on Axis Bank, at least gap up has happened, and it is trying to inch on the higher side. Now when I see Axis Bank, there is a large amount of resistance on the higher side of 547. Right. So once this level has to be breached, then straight away 566 is there on the cards. So it will take time. So out of Yes Bank, Axis Bank, and ICICI Bank, I would say Yes Bank is on the top, then Axis Bank, and then ICICI Bank. So that's the bank. Let's take the HDFC Twins. So HDFC Bank is providing good support, because if you see over here, today gap up opening of HDFC Bank, and it is trying to inch high. One thing is pretty much clear, after this slant fall which took place, it has now formed a double bottom over here. So this is one and this is two, and it is inched higher. Most importantly, what I was thinking, there is a good resistance zone around this 1800 and 1900 mark. But what happens today, it opens gap up and it basically breaches all the highs which are there, which basically shows there is a good upside in HDFC Bank, right? Now we need to understand this can become a very good structural point to discuss and to understand. So what I'm trying to say, this is on the higher resistance zone where it is currently trading 1900 or so. So it might not breach just one way up. It might take some time to breach this. But if it comes back down roughly around 20 bucks or so, that is 1896 kind of levels, and you can get a reversal, there's a good upside for HDFC Bank, right? So there is around 30-40 points upside for HDFC Bank, and that basically will provide amazing support to Bank Nifty as well. So that basically clearly shows, if Axis Bank, HDFC Bank are ready to perform, Kotak IndusInd Bank is performing, it basically can give good upside to the Bank Nifty. So this is what I was trying to pull out. If you see, there was a gap up, it was trying to inch higher, and now it is in the important resistance mark, right? So this is very important resistance mark on the upside, because the fall had taken place around these levels, and this was the gap which was there on the higher side. So if HDFC Bank comes down and maybe basically for a day, if it comes down, if Nifty Bank Nifty tries to go on the sideways, it can become a structurally good bet, because it should not go down now below the gap which is formed today. Right, so 1880 becomes a huge base level for HDFC Bank, and that is clearly a good signature support now for HDFC Bank if it comes down. And the important point, if it breaches this level, right, and this 1910 is taken out, as I was saying, It can go straight away to 35.40 because this is the prior gap, but the fall was steep. The rise can also be faster. So finding 1960, 1980 on HDFC Bank is not at all difficult, but we need to understand first whether it can reach this level or not. If it comes back, it tries to inch higher. 1940 is the next stop, right? So if you can get a hand on HDFC Bank around this 1900 odd levels, straight away 1940 is clearly visible on HDFC Bank, and that will also provide Bank Nifty to inch higher towards 25,700 or so. So that's it for the day. Banks are trying to provide support, number one. And number two, we have autos which are in play. So keep an eye on Maruti and Bajaj Auto, which can show you a good strength which is coming. Thank you very much for joining in, and we'll connect again tomorrow.